Things are going so bad for Florida Governor Ron DeSantis on the campaign trail that analysts within the Republican Party are now recommending that he just pull himself off the campaign trail altogether. Now, that doesn't mean that they think he should stop campaigning for president, right? They don't want him to end his campaign. They just want him to go away for a little while they try to figure out what the hell is going so wrong for him. As one strategist puts it, she said, Governor DeSantis cannot get within striking reach of Donald Trump, and every time he makes a campaign stop, voters seem to step back. So, to put it another way, which is what I've been saying for over a year now, every time Ron DeSantis goes out there and meets people, even if they had supported him, those people are now less likely to support him after meeting him personally, after having those one-on-one interactions. People walk away and say, yeah, I'm not doing that anymore. And what's really great, by the way, I was on vacation all last week, so it's taken me a little while to get caught up on the news. But one thing that was actually brought to my attention was that a clip of me from Ring of Fire was actually used in a online DeSantis campaign ad. And in that ad, I was talking about, well, I wasn't in the ad, I didn't approve it. But they did show a clip of me where I explained that Ron DeSantis is, of course, scarier than Donald Trump because DeSantis has succeeded where Trump has failed. Now, the reason I'm even bringing that up is because I have no idea how far back they had to dig to find that clip of me saying, oh, DeSantis is a scary candidate. Because if you've been paying attention to these videos over the last, you know, 2 or 3 months, I have said the exact opposite. DeSantis is no longer a scary candidate. DeSantis has proven that he is, in fact, a failure on the campaign trail, which is why ever since the day he announced that he is officially running for president, his poll numbers have gone down, not up. And that is another thing, by the way, in these multiple reports that have come out, where you have Republican strategists and analysts and even those close to DeSantis saying his polls are going in the wrong direction. But they think they got an ace up their sleeve, right? So while they want DeSantis himself, they want Ron off the campaign trail. They want another DeSantis instead to take his place. And that DeSantis is Florida's First Lady, Casey DeSantis, Ron's wife. They believe that she is likable, she is approachable, she is personable. You know, she's a good person, they think. She is the kind of person, the kind of face to put out there on this campaign to show people, hey, it's okay, come on back. Look, we're not creepy and weird. The whole DeSantis family isn't a bunch of weirdos. I'm totally normal. That's what they're hoping to do. And this coming Thursday, Casey is going to be in Iowa with the governor, Republican governor of Iowa, launching what they're calling Mamas for DeSantis. Mamas for DeSantis to try to, you know, shore up the fact that women are especially repulsed by Ron DeSantis. So they're starting this new branch of the campaign, Mamas for DeSantis, so they can maybe try to bring some women back into the fold. Even after Ron recently signed an abortion ban here in the state of Florida, which, of course, turned off a lot of women. He actually also recently, just a day or two ago, signed legislation that has pissed off Republican women in the state. He now has Republican women angry with him because he's done away with permanent alimony in the state, which a lot of these, you know, elderly retirees are relying on. They say that, you know, I would understand it if I was a Democrat, but I'm a Republican and they're not listening to me. That's actually a quote, by the way, from one of these angry women. But they think Casey DeSantis can shore it up. They think Casey DeSantis can go out there and prove that Ron doesn't hate all women. But based on other reports, kind of seems like Casey might be the one with the big ambitions, that she may be the puppet master behind the scenes pulling the strings on Ron, making him do what he clearly is not good enough to be doing. So we'll see. Maybe Casey can right the ship, but maybe, at this point, they're just rearranging deck chairs on the Titanic. Thanks for watching, everyone, and, well, here comes the awkward part at the end of the video, where I ask you to like, comment, and share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire.
Also, you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description.